the fact that I'm kind of growing up with the character, and the character is aging too, which is really cool. You don't see that a whole lot in animated shows. They kind of stay, you know, 10 or 12 years old the whole however many seasons. And we're all a lot like our characters, for the most part. Like, if you look at me, I'm kind of a lot like Finn, or John is, you know, this big guy with red hair. He's a lot like Jake. Olivia, that plays Marceline, is like a rocker chick in real life. She's just like her character. So it's kind of cool that we all kind of have a similar essence to our actual characters. About 100% of the lines, actually. No, I mean, you have the lines, and I'm thinking, like, I asked them, like, oh, is this a typo? They're like, no, it's just as written. I'm like, okay. And then those turn into, like, the big, you know, catchphrases and stuff. So they make sense later. You're like, oh, okay. You know, people grab onto this and start saying it in real life that are completely made up words. The writing team obviously writes them, but I think it's a mix of kind of the writing team, and then it's kind of a good connection there, because the way we'll deliver the lines, or, you know, say them, kind of turns it even that much more into a cool catchphrase, as opposed to just being like, oh, schmauzow. It's like, schmauzow, you know, or something like that, or slam a cow. And they just become huge from there, you know. Some of that stuff, like how it came about, like, I almost have a hard time remembering because I was so little. But I just remember I started acting, and I started doing like commercials and stuff, and some on-camera TV stuff, and then I just kind of worked my way into doing voiceover, and I started doing, like, you know, like little radio spots for little things here and there, you know, whatever. And then you start getting to go out for animation or things like that, and just the more you work, the more you kind of get auditions for other stuff, and they kind of start saying, oh, why don't you come in and try this? And I used to do a lot of ADR looping, which is like, you know, you kind of put your voice over other people's lips and stuff, which is kind of how that came about, the My Neighbors the Yamadas, which is difficult to do, but it's really cool, it's really fun. We have to do that with Adventure Time sometimes, actually, because now that we have the episodes coming into Australia, some stuff is, like, I guess not appropriate for Australia that is in the US, so we'll have to dub over certain lines and, like, change them a little bit and tweak them. Oh, yeah, totally. I mean, the cool thing was, we got the audition and breakdown, and I guess my dad and him had remembered him doing it. And so we looked up the old short that was on YouTube, and my voice sounded a ton like his when he did it. And so I even kind of copied it, or just tweaked it a little bit to kind of get into the character. But it was pretty similar just to my normal voice at that point. And then I auditioned, and they were like, oh my gosh, this kid sounds just like him. And nobody except for Penn knew that I was even his brother until I booked the job. I started having to kind of make it into more of a character voice, because obviously it doesn't sound like my normal voice now. It's kind of more appearing, you know, in my you know, 12 or 13 year old voice. So now it's, for the past like 4 or 5 seasons, it's been the same. People always ask me, like, oh, what's gonna happen? They're gonna replace your voice? Are you gonna go through voice change? I'm like, I already did during the whole first season. You know, if you, people that really have a good ear can actually hear it happening. And that's where a lot of the, actually, the character came in, like, when Finn does the crazy screams, there's a lot of voice crack. Initially, that was just kind of a natural thing, because you're going through puberty, your voice cracks. But now it's kind of something that Finn just does, and I've kind of been able to turn it off and on, too, just like the voice. I love doing on camera. I love doing voiceover. I love being able to do both, because they're both so very different, and I think any real actor loves doing different things. It's kind of what makes you an actor. And I was already working on Adventure Time when that show came around, and so I knew Cartoon Network, but at that point I was just the kid that did the voice of Finn. But then I auditioned, and I had to just do a couple different sketch characters, basically, and I did a few, and then I guess they liked it, and I got the job. And from there, it was just such a cool learning experience, being able to do all these different sketch characters and stuff, just like, you know, a small version of SNL, which is just really fun. I love doing that show. Like, the running errands to my mom, or there's one called, like, Doug High, where they digitally made, like, it was like a high school of all just me's, basically, and they digitally, like, imposed me, like, you know, hanging out with myself in different scenes and stuff. That was really fun. I love being able to connect with my fans that way, at least, like, through Instagram, like, just kind of show them what I'm up to, what I'm doing, like, you know, when I'm here and stuff, I can take a picture and put a funny caption. Or on Twitter, send out stuff, and then sometimes, you know, go back and forth. Same with on Facebook, you know, just kind of communicate with them occasionally and stuff, as much as I can. It's hard to do that constantly, because you're busy, you're working and stuff. But it's good to give back, because you have to remember that I wouldn't be where I am if it wasn't for the fans that love the show and have kept it going, obviously, because they love it, so. Hey guys, I'm Jeremy Shada, the voice of Finn on Adventure Time, and you're watching Mad Men's YouTube channel.